rapey yaoi, but in a good way.
Ooh, yaoi review.
Hi everybody, it's Corbin, and today we are going to be talking about Jazz, Volume 1, by Tamatsu Takamura and Sakai Madaida. Alright, this is published by June. We shall read the back, and we shall delve into it. Nike's illness haunts him like a curse until he meets the one person who gives him a vibrant life. Like a slow jazz refrain, thoughts of his beloved float through every waking moment. But can he make his caretaker's heart sing back? A wounded soul never fully recovers. Will Naiko's suffer the painful blow of unrequited love? Long after the last notes of freedom melody fade into the black of the club, the lingering refrain of jazz will ensnare you. A love-struck tale that moves to its own dizzy beat. This one story that promises a little something for every hopeful heart. This is rated 18+. Now, the way this story opens up is kind of a little confusing. It opens up with a future tense that kind of throws us into the middle of the story of the main plot point for the beginning chapter. It's beautifully drawn. It keeps you interested, so you follow along. Now, the way the story starts, in order for us to get the real plot line, it's a doctor who's on call who gets a call saying his patients come into the emergency room and they're having a severe asthma attack and the medication's not working. And we just see the whole thing kind of spiral from there. The patient falls in love with the doctor and the doctor doesn't really get it. Now, the first real instance where we see the doctor understanding the patient really has the hots for him is when the patient takes him out to dinner after the patient graduates from high school and kind of date rapes him. He slips something, a Mickey, into his drink, and the doctor wakes up at his in a hotel and they have sex. It's very kind of sleazy and scuzzy. Now, I personally, that was where I started to turn off. I was going to say this was the worst yaoi in the universe, but then it started to build up and kind of become that obsessive love story that I enjoy reading and I thoroughly find pleasurable to read. The patient really does love the doctor. The doctor seems to have very mixed or kind of tipsy, silly views on whether or not he loves the patient, when it's more than obvious by anyone who's just watching from the outside that he absolutely is infatuated with the guy. So it follows through with that, and then finally the doctor says, I've had enough, I can't handle this, I don't know what's going on with me, and I'm just going to run away to America to study abroad. And it just kind of seems like it's going to flutter out and die until the patient goes, I know where he lives, I'm going to go stalk him again, please don't reject me. Now, there's a lot of sex in this. I mean, the whole plot point kind of arcs at them, the patient showing up in America to find him. So, you know they're going to end up together. They show them ending the Volume 1 with a kiss. There's a lot of sex in it. It's a positive. It really is. It's very interesting, but it's all rapey sex. There isn't really any, oh, I love you, let's do this. It's kind of like, oh, I love you, gimme, and takey. So, that's one thing. I thought that was... Secondly, it is a very well-drawn, it is very pretty, but it's that dated kind of mid-80s to mid-90s kind of art style. So, I mean, it shows its age. Now, I liked it. I really did. I gave this a 3.5 stars. It wasn't going to be anywhere close to 4 because it is very much so a very, very, very rapey yaoi. Personally, I don't like those kind of yaois often, so in this case, it wasn't like, oh my god, it's rape, but it was also not bad, if that makes sense. So if you guys have questions or comments, shoot them down below, give me a like, a thumbs up, share this with a friend who likes yaoi, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.
You like what you see? Then...
Subscribe!